tips there, make it a little thicker. And then you've got the handle section is wrapped in leather that came from, actually from an old coat. And that's stitched in place there at the end. The string was paracord and has just been kind of glued and stitched together at the end there. As you may know, the point of traditional archery isn't just to shoot, it's to shoot in such a way that your skill or your practice or your desire to hit the target is the deciding factor and not that you just happen to have better stabilizers or sights or anything like that there. Now, that's not to minimize what people do with non-traditional archery equipment and with Olympic recurve or with the cams and wheels on a compound bow. Archery is still archery. You're still shooting an arrow through the air. You still have to be able to aim. You still have to be able to figure out where it's going to go and how it's going to get there. And you still have to have the strength to pull the bow. One of the things people often overlook is that bows are not easy to pull. Historical or fantasy fiction, a lot of times the bow is given to the person who's slight of build. The reality is that pulling a bow, you get a lot of, it's mostly in your back, to be honest, to be fair, but the arm that holds the bow out, you do get, especially on the outer part of the bow. I was shooting for 2 hours with my other homemade bow. My other homemade bow is a 71-inch long bow. Carved out of hickory, but it's natural, it's not stained or anything. That's sort of a square or rectangular cross section. And that's 45 pounds draw weight. For reference, my store bought recurve is only about 40 pounds, and since I don't have a full 28 inch draw, I'm not pulling that. The longbow was, the hickory longbow was 42 pounds at my draw length of around 26 inches. And I shot that for almost 2 hours or so. And one of the things I noticed, even with finger protection, and at one point I had this on, at one point I had the glove, my two lowermost fingers got really, really sore. And of course, right around 1 o'clock in the morning, this part of the whole part of my arm was feeling it. And I think that was from holding up. So, despite what D&D or Lord of the Rings would have you believe, archery is not for the physically slight. You have to build up to it. You start with a lower draw weight, and you just get the hang of doing it without hurting yourself or damaging your gear, and then you go to a higher draw weight. And of course, certain things help. Recurves are a little smoother, and compound bow has a mechanical advantage and a let off, so you're not holding the full draw weight once you pull it back. Something like this, or like the English longbow, or the American style longbow, like the one I made, you're holding the full poundage and there's no mechanical advantage or anything technological to help you. It's made out of a solid piece of wood most of the time, and you're holding it at its full weight. This is a short bow, so it doesn't draw back quite as full as a normal recurve from the store or as my longbow does. I would have taken the longbow out, but after shooting it all day yesterday, I was like, I don't want to do that again for a day or two. And it's worth noting that historically bows, whether you're talking longbows or anything else that were used for warfare, for battle, were typically much higher than 40-some pounds. And again, it's worth noting that historically, traditional bows, whether you're talking a long bow or whether you're talking some other bow that were used for warfare, were much higher poundage. They seem to start around 80 or 90 and go up to over 120. Not just traditional archery in the sense of a recurve over a compound, but homemade bows, self bows, that sort of thing, whether it's a long bow or something like this flat bow. And I think a lot of the appeal is people looking at the way things were in the past and saying, could we still do that? Could we replicate it? Almost like experimental archaeology. It's no surprise that a lot of the people that are into this are also into either historical or post-apocalyptic fiction, where the situations where the ability to make something like this and use it, and not just for target practice, would be of practical importance. But I think there's also a desire to see, what can I do? Traditional bows. Why would somebody decide to make their own bow and or even arrow? Again, I think a lot of it comes back to the challenge of to seeing, what can I do? It's hard enough to shoot the bow and hit the target, but to make your own bow, or arrow, or anything else, and have it function. You know, there's a satisfaction to being able to say, I made that. I didn't just shoot it, I made it. A lot of times working with your hands is something that allows you to send your mind down other avenues to think and to wonder and to ponder. And so just the act of making the bow is, it's relaxing. It's and it's also a challenge, again, in and of itself, just like shooting it. You know, to be able to do that, to be able to say, I've made this, and actually have it work, that's pretty cool. I'm not sure I'd trade that feeling for anything else.